Student friends, in yesterday's lecture we studied the IV characteristics of depletion enhancement MOSFET, that is a DMOSFET. That completes the study of DMOSFET, where we have studied the construction of DMOSFET, working of DMOSFET, and IV characteristics of depletion enhancement MOSFET. Today we are going to study another type of MOSFET that is known as E-MOSFET. E-MOSFET means it is enhancement metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. This FET has the ability to work only in enhancement mode. It doesn't work in depletion mode. Friends, up till now whatever we have covered, as per a junction FET is there, its gate and source junction is reverse biased. As long as gate to source voltage is zero, channel width is more, hence the drain current is more. But as we go on increasing gate to source voltage, naturally depletion layer increases, this will reduce the channel width. So that's why drain current reduces. Means as we go on increasing gate to source voltage negatively, channel width decreases, at the cost of which the drain current reduces. In DMOSFET we studied that it operates in both. When it will be made to work in depletion mode, gate to source must be reverse biased. But when it is to be made to work in the enhancement mode, it should be in forward biased mode. But E-MOSFET is made to be operated only in enhancement mode. Whenever it will start conducting the current, it will go to enhancement mode and then it is going to work. Such a FET we can call it as it is E-MOSFET, that is enhancement metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. The N-channel E-MOSFET is constructed as represented in this particular figure. To understand the structure of enhancement N-channel MOSFET, let me consider N type of semiconducting bar. This entire bar is of N type. On this N type of semiconducting bar, exactly on this center, P type of semiconducting layer is deposited, and that particular P type of layer which is deposited, it is known as a substrate. Sometimes it is called as sealed. On one side of that particular entire P type of semiconducting layer up to which it is deposited, SiO2 layer is coated. This SiO2 layer is going to act as insulating layer, or it is going to act as isolation layer. On other side of isolation, ohmic metallic contact is taken, and that terminal is named as the gate. Means here gate is of P type. Also ohmic contact is taken from bottom of N type of semiconductor. It is known as a source terminal. Whereas ohmic contact is taken from the top of the N type of semiconductor, it is known as drain. Thus, the enhancement N-channel MOSFET has four terminals: source, drain, gate, and seal or substrate. This was the structure of enhancement N-channel MOSFET is being considered. So here is the P-channel MOSFET is represented. This is just for your observation purpose. Exactly opposite of this, we can get the structure of the enhancement MOSFET but with the p channel. Same structure is represented here. Look at here. Here is the n type of semiconducting bar. Exactly on the center, p type of semiconducting layer is deposited. It is called as a substrate or sealed. On one of the side of p type of semiconducting bar, SiO2 layer is coated, which is going to act as isolation layer or insulating layer. Exactly on the opposite side, ohmic contact is taken. It is called as a gate. Routinely, ohmic contacts are taken from bottom as well as top, respectively known as source and drain. This is what the structure or construction of n-channel e-MOSFET is considered. The symbol of n-channel e-MOSFET is represented here. It has substrate, drain, gate and the source. Arrow is represented on the substrate, or it is also represented on the source terminal. This is also the symbol of e-MOSFET, whereas this is also the symbol of e-MOSFET. Arrow indicates that it is of n-channel e-MOSFET. Now let us see how e-MOSFET works. As we are aware that e-MOSFET works only in the enhancement mode. Physically, it doesn't contain any type of channel, because total bar is of n type of semiconducting and this entire central part is coated by p type of semiconducting layer. As long as that particular p type of semiconducting layer is there, it is lightly doped, very thin, it has a high resistance, it doesn't allow that particular EMOS to conduct at the beginning. Therefore, the enhanced channel must be generated to work e-MOSFET. Routinely, as far as biasing of e-MOSFET is considered, the gate and source must be forward biased now. Means as FET is of n-channel, gate is of p-type. So that's why to the gate, positive terminal of the battery VCC is connected, whereas the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the source. This is what forward biasing. When it is forward biased, naturally the SiO2 layer is going to start acting it as a dielectric constant, dielectric media. Hence on gate side, positive charges will start developing, whereas within on in p region on the n-type of semiconducting bar, negative charges may going to likely to be developed. That depends upon how much amount of gate to source voltage that we are applying. At the beginning, when VCC is zero, no charges will develop, as a being p layer is entirely spreaded, it doesn't allow emitted charge carriers to enter into the drain, even though drain and source is forward biased. No doubt that drain and source is forward biased, source will liberate the charge carrier electrons, but as being entire region is covered by means of a lightly doped p type of semiconducting bar, these charges doesn't reach to the drain, hence drain current is zero. Meaning thereby, when gate to source voltage is zero, then liberated charge carriers doesn't reaches to the drain, and that's why the drain current is zero. But when you go on increasing VCC, when you go on increasing VGS slightly, on gate side, slight positive charges are developed, or within the P region, negative charges are developed. Here is the process of enhancement that starts. And hence, an artificial conducting channel starts creating, due to which emitted charge carriers will start repelling from the channel and they will start moving towards the drain so as to increase the drain current. As you go on increasing VCC further, more and more charge carriers are generated in the P region so that the enhancement process begins due to enhanced channel created. Liberated electrons, charge carriers will move towards the drain so as to increase the drain current. Thus, due to enhancement process, the drain current starts flowing through the drain. This is the peculiarity of working of enhancement metal oxide field effect transistor. This FET works only in enhancement mode. This doesn't work in rest of the modes itself. So friends, that's what you have to remember about the structure of E-MOSFET and also the working of enhancement metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor.